At the beginning, God, the Creator, had a dream. That is why He created all things in resemblance to His form. He began with the creation of the worlds of the minerals, plants, and animals, and finally a man and a woman who would become the dawn of humankind. God also created a period of growth for them. Human beings have a responsibility to grow in absolute oneness with God, yet that did not happen. Therefore, a fallen human race was born which had no relation to God. For the omniscient and omnipotent God, the beginning and the end must be the same. There could be no failure. Thus, God began the providence of salvation. He must restore the principle of creation, which He had originally established. Ajo.
You know, last several months, we were focusing on our big rally last Monday, and actually it was really amazing. You know, most of us were there, and we all really bring a lot of people. And it was so amazing to see. It was filled with probably 80% people from other Christian churches. It was truly amazing. Let's give a big round of applause. You know, I truly believe it was a big victory for God's providence. And we can continue that. Even though some of us could not hear the translation, it's available right now online. And it was truly a miracle that we were able to bring that many people from different Christian churches. We had over 200 churches were present there. And that was only from Christian churches. And I know we had many Muslims there, many Hindus there, and almost all kind of religious people were there. It was truly an amazing victory we were able to achieve at the Nasavu Veterans Memorial Coliseum. And I want to thank all of you. It's the result of all of your hard work, all of our hard work. I know many of you were every day visiting Christian churches, inviting people, not only on Sundays, even other days also. I know brothers and sisters were going to different churches and inviting their members, their pastors. And also I know many people were inviting other people from the streets and inviting your relatives, your friends, and donating for the program. Many, many ways we all work together. That's why we were able to bring that victory. I know even like a few days before, Mrs. Gime met a church, and then they miraculously, surprisingly, they all came. Just 3 or 4 days before, she went there and they were able to come there. And I really want to thank all of you. We did a great job. You did a great job. Let's give a big round of applause. Also, I want to thank, you know, all the families of children who participated in the flower presentation. You know, they had to go there early and to get ready, and it was really great. I was so happy to see the picture with the True Mother, all of our young members. All of them are from New Jersey. I think you all know them. Thank you. And Eriko-san and Mrs. Jewel prepared the flowers, and I was happy that I brought the flowers and gave. I was really glad to see that. You know, yeah, thank you so much, all of your hard work. You know, after the main event, I was able to attend 2 victory celebrations, and actually 1 victory celebration and 1 yesterday, a Thanksgiving celebration, or Thanksgiving dinner with the True Mother. And I felt True Mother want to always talk to us, you know, almost same as what she talked in the victory celebration right after the program. She was talking about, even in the main celebration, talking about the dream of God. God have a dream, or had a dream, and still God keep that dream. even though it did not realize in the very beginning. And in order to achieve that, our True Mother is going around the world. And that dream was for all of us. Dream about humanity. Dream about all men and women. And that dream is almost forgotten by the world. And that's why True Mother came here to remind our country, to tell all of us. Did you hear that? What's that? Yeah, you know, True Mother wants all of us to have peaceful life. For individuals, True Mother wants her children, which means every individual in this world, to be free, to be peaceful. And she wants all of our families to have peace in their families, enjoy life in their families, and the world, and the whole world, she wants to have peace in this world. That's why she was here and spent several days with us. And I heard tomorrow, True Mother is going to Africa and then going to Nepal. And all this travel at this age, she is doing because she wants us to be okay. She wants us to have a good life. That's where she is going around the world. And what do we do about this? Do we have to do something? Or do we should we start preparing for the next rally? I think we should. Do you want? Yes, we should. You know, I think everyone really enjoyed sometimes, you know, reaching out. We have calling team several days, several times. We, like many of our brothers and sisters, even from here, and some of our brothers and sisters from their homes, calling all of our membership. And even beyond that, and encouraging everyone, let's come together and make this happen. It creates a lot of unity, a lot of enthusiasm among our membership. And so we have to do it again, but next week. Okay. Next Sunday, we have Sunday service here. But we don't have to wait for the next big program to continue that, to continue our work in establishing that peace kingdom, or really realizing the dream of God. You know, it's not a one-time thing. You know, how many of you have visited a dentist? I'm surprised, not so many. Are you hearing me? How many of you have been to a dentist office? Please raise everyone who went. You know, it's no, I was told when I was young that I should have at least 2 deep cleaning a year, and I should visit dentist at least 2 times a year in order to keep your teeth healthy. And every time I go to a dentist, I don't like that so much. And I feel sometimes pain, sometimes, you know, many times, you know, we went to, then they want to drill your, take out something or put another thing and things like that. So I don't really, I try to avoid. Actually, up until I started going to Dr. Takesawa. He's here. Dr. Takesawa is here. Sorry to put you on spot, but Anyway, after I started going to Dr. Takesau, he's there. I know where he sits every week, so he's there. After I went there, everything got changed. My perception about dentist, and also my oral health got changed. And usually, ever since, I remember my first time I'm visiting dentist, I was 9th or 8th grade, something. And I didn't like that. And it was kind of very thorough cleaning, and then she wanted to fill one hole I had. That was kind of really horrible experience. But when I went to Dr. Takesawa's place, he was totally different. Do you know what he did? Maybe some of you have same experience. What's that? He talked to me, that's true. But once, something I never expected, he brushed my teeth. I never expected that. And he brushed my teeth one by one, and he was teaching me how to brush. Actually, I'm pretty good in brushing my teeth, because one time I remember when I was in, one of my Sunday school teacher told me I should, instead of brushing like this, I should brush like up and down. And then I always tell my kids, but they don't really do that. Even Rani don't really do that. But Dr. Takesawa brushed all my tooth one by one, up and down, and then show me how to even brush from inside, everyone, one by one. This is first time, I'm 45 years old, first time in my life, somebody this many years, someone show me, one dentist showing me how to brush my teeth. And I was amazed. And then that made me thinking, wow, he's not there to drill my teeth. He's to take care of my oral health. He's showing me, telling me, explaining me, and how we should, and every day brush your teeth 2 times and do flossing. That's also, these 2 things, very important. And that way, I can have good health in my mouth. My teeth will be okay, my gums will be okay if I do that every day. Actually, when I did that first time, when I went to Dr. Takesawa, after that, I did for a few weeks, then I missed that. Then I went, again he asked me, I think now I went to his office maybe 4 or 5 times, or maybe even more. But every time when I go there, he asked me, do you floss? Do you brush? How do you brush? He asked me. And then she showed me again and again. Wow. That was really amazing thing for me. And even my children, all of them brush their teeth properly now. And then we sometimes, even last time when we came back, it was last time he showed them how to do that. Then they were kind of, in a way, they felt so strange. He was brushing their teeth, but they were so happy. After that, they started doing that. You know, I felt, but what I learned from before, in my understanding, you have to go to what everyone tell you. You have to go to dentist 2 times a year. What happens if you don't brush your teeth and go to dentist 2 times a year? Probably many of those dentists will be very happy, because they can do a lot in your, maybe do many, many root canals, and then take out some teeth and put new tooth, and then, okay, come back after 6 months. But that doesn't give you, that won't give you true oral health. In order to have true health, in order to really keep your gums healthy, your teeth healthy, you have to do this brushing every day 2 times, consistently. Then you have good health. And that's kind of same thing with our life in general, you know, our spiritual life as well as our physical life, in order to have good health physically, we have to have good habits every day. Not once in 6 months, or not once in a year. You have to have certain habits, eating proper food every day, on time, and also exercising every day, on time, and also waking up, going back to sleep every day, regularly. And this kind of things give you physical health. And same way, we have to have spiritual practices, like reading Hunduke every day, a commitment, even if it is little bit less and more, and you have to do it every day. Prayer, it has to be a practice. It should not be a condition for 40 days and then, next 40 days, I don't have to do anything. I'm glad it's finished. I don't have to do anymore. It should not be like that. It has to be something regular, something we do as part of our life without really disturbing other things we do in our life. Everything has to be a balanced, regular act, regular good habits. And that's where we will be able to truly, truly have good spiritual health. And today, I want to encourage you, I want to tell you that our true mother came here, even still here, in order for us to give a good life. She's going to Africa to remind people of Africa that they need a good life. They need peaceful life. You know, peacefulness and happiness and everything, it should not be just when we are here in 1 week and Sunday service and we have that 3 minutes or 5 minutes greeting each other. It should not be just during that time we are having happiness and we greet each other, we have good life. We have to have all the time. We have to have that as part of our life. Calling our friend, calling one of our family member, it should not be just for inviting them to one of our big program once a year. We make it as our life. Then we can truly make that as a, you may not see anything like in 1 or 2 days, there may not be any change. But when we look back after many years, we can see a tremendous progress in our life, a tremendous achievement we will be able to make if we have that kind of habits in our life as consistently, day to day, every day, if we do that. You know, many times we, in our families, we need to have a habit of cooking food, eating together, and that's, it should not be just like on a birthday time or something. It has to be every day. And it's actually proven that children who have breakfast from their home and go to school, they study well, and they emotionally also, they are very healthier compared to other children. And also, between our relationship between our husband and wife, it should not be a relationship where we can go once a month, we go for a nice dinner outside, and then that's very good. I like that. But more than that, we need to have a habit where we take care of each other within our home. You know, sometimes we think about having a wonderful vacation once a year. We dream about that. I want to go to Disney this year. I'm kind of saving money for going for that dream vacation with my family. Many of us dream that, and some of us can't even make that. But it is much more important that we have a better relationship. We have that daily habits within our home of treating everyone in our home properly. And that's what I, especially right now, nowadays, I'm talking about this because in the last several weeks, we were intense busy. And some of us were, like yes, I had some of our leaders were not even going back to their homes, staying in headquarters because how intense, because it was an intense battle. But in order for to truly reach that, we need to, that dream, in order to achieve that dream our true parents are talking about, we really need to make that from ourselves. You know that theme we talk about? What was the theme? Peace start with me. And that's where, that's the thing. And that has to start with me, with all of us, without really worrying about, oh, is my neighbor really taking care of himself? Is he? But I'm really thinking about myself. How can I have peace? And then how can my family members have that same peace? I wonder how for myself. When we continue that way, when we have peace in myself and within my family, then we will be able to make everlasting peace in this world. And that's where True Mother going everywhere, reminding everyone. And I want to encourage you, please prepare ourselves that way. And that way, we will be truly listening to our True Mother's speech and then truly responding properly to our True Mother's calling to the entire humanity. And that way, we are truly making an example for our brothers and sisters, our friends, and our co-workers, and everyone we are meeting in our life. And also, I want to encourage you, many of you invited many, many guests, and some of you are inviting many, many Christian pastors, many, many ministers, their members, and them also have a, make a plan with them. And it doesn't have to be really big things, but make small, short things in maybe have a half an hour education session. It doesn't have to be like an education session per se, but just meet with them once a week or once a month and have a meal together with them and take care of them and let them take care of us. And that way, we are truly continuing that unity we started. We were talking about working together with Christianity. It is not just teaching Christianity. It is working together, learning from them, and share our best practices with them. And that way, we will be able to continue what our True Mother started this last Monday and show us how to do that. And even when I attended a victory celebration next morning also, True Mother is telling us, you are the owners of this country. As owners, you have to start that. You have to even start a true family movement in order to save this country. And that true family movement also start with our family. Start with myself. I need to have that realization. I need to constantly remind myself without forgetting. And I need to constantly think that my family is the center for me. And that family, in this family, I need to create peace. And it is so difficult. That is the most difficult thing for each and every one of us. It is much easier for us to do other things. In fact, creating happiness within our family, creating a true relationship, a smooth relationship between children and parents, between husband and wife, that is the biggest thing for us. And we need to let us focus on that, and through our everyday actions, through our everyday habits. And when we do that, we will be able to really have that peace kingdom, that everlasting peace. Peace for humanity will be realized by that. You know, last few months, I'm completely following Dr. Takesawa's suggestion or his guidance. I do every day. Even if I go back kind of really late in home, I want to sleep without doing anything, I still do my brushing of teeth because I felt I need to do that. And then after this last few months, I felt it's really good. I did not have any toothache or any of that kind of problems, and it works. And that way, in our families, if we do like with consistency, and there may be a problem, like, you know, sometimes when I was young, I was told that don't eat sugar, don't eat sweet items so that you will get teeth problem. But I think if you properly brush, it's okay. And what I mean is that even if you have a argument or fighting or something in your home, still keep that commitment. Still keep that the habits of forgiveness, habits of embracing people and embracing our husband or wife, and then come together in the evening and do the prayer and close the night by solving all the problems we had. When we have that, it'll be wonderful. And then you wake up, thank God. God, I'm so glad I'm alive. I'm so glad that you gave me one more day. And then do the best things. And even when you talk to people, think and imagine that God gave me this voice. God gave me this ability to speak in order to uplift other people, in order to bring the love of God to people. And this, when we think about that, we can act much better. And even when we deal with our children, deal with our husband or wife, think that I'm here because God gave me this chance. God gave me this family for me to take care. Remember that all the time and act accordingly. And even when you meet your friends, remember those such kind of things, then you will be able to really achieve everlasting peace. You know, this. Every time when we have a bigger event, it's a big support for us to reach out to hundreds of people, reach out perhaps thousands of people. Then it really what give us the real result is that how do you continue that relationship you have made? And how do you nurture those relationships you have made? And if you're thinking about just filling up the hall, then after that, okay, bye-bye, thank you, you came, and then see you next year if we have a program, then we can never achieve. And many years, and so many of our previous years, we were doing that way, and it's maybe in one sense, it's not anyone's fault because we have always some big things happening. And I want to suggest to you, even if we have big rallies every month, find time in between those big events that you have to take it to do these little things. When you do these little things, it won't hurt you so much. It won't really take a lot of time, lot of energy, lot of money away from our families and of individuals, but it give you long-lasting results. It is like investing in mutual funds, investing little by little, but at the end, you get a big amount of money without even realizing you were investing something. And that's the way we really have to create our heavenly kingdom and try to make good habits. Discuss with your family, discuss with your children, and then find out what kind of things you can do as a family, which it doesn't have to be a big thing. It should not be anything hurt your family's finances. It should not be anything which is really, really hurting your children's school schedule. It should not be something really you have to take a big off from your work or something like that. But it has to be something which you can easily adapt into your daily life. And those kind of habits, you find out, what do you want to do together as a family? Then continue that. It should not be something bothersome for you. It should not be something like you are inviting our other church family, and then you get panicked that, oh my God, I have to clean my house, I have to cook this big meal. Don't be that way. Even if you invite someone, take it lightly. It should not be something, inviting one of your friends should not be a burdensome problem for you. It has to be something you can enjoy. It has to be something that benefits you as well as the other family. When you do that way, it is something uplifting. It is something we can just sit together calmly and talk calmly. That way, it is something really enjoyable, and then it will really bring you towards a better life. Otherwise, if it is something painful thing, like inviting one friend of yours to your family, and it's going to take like many days for you to prepare, and it's kind of really give you a lot of headache, don't do that. I'm telling you, don't take such kind of headache in your life. Do things which help you. Do things which give you peace. Do things which give peace to other people. Do things which give peace to your children and your husband and your wife. In that way, we are building peace in this world. You may not really see that immediate connection between your family and 7.4 billion people. How do we are always worried about that, because true parents always talk about them. But we are one among that. Me, I am one of that 7.4 billion people in this world. And you all are. And our families are. When we have peace in that way, in my life, and in my family, and in your life and your family, you are totally, totally aligned with true parents. You are completely aligned with God. You are realizing God's dream in this world through fulfilling what you have to do for yourself and for your family. And without that, you can't have peace in this world. If you think, I kill myself and you kill yourself, and then you can create peace in this world, I don't think so. It cannot happen. And that's why I want to ask you, when I made that habit, initially it was a little bit of difficult for me to completely have that habit in me. And even now, it is not easy, but every day I'm pushing myself to brush my teeth and floss myself every morning and evening. And things are getting easier and easier. And even those rough edges you have when you floss, that's gone. And so it is going to be easier when you continue that for a while. And at one point, it becomes part of your everyday life. Without even realizing you will start doing. We have to be people like that. And that's what our true parents want us to be. And that's what our God, our heavenly parent, want us to be. They want, remember our 2020 motto. We promise every day that we will become like our heavenly parent. And this way, when we become peaceful enough, we become like our heavenly parent. When our family become peaceful enough and joyful enough, we are totally embodying that heavenly parent within our family. And that way we are directly contributing to that, building that eternal heavenly kingdom in this world. And that's what I want to remind all of you today. After this great victory we have achieved in Nassau Veterans Memorial Coliseum, let us do that in our families. And let us focus in our small little communities. We can have an impact. And by doing so, we are totally aligned with our heavenly parent. We're totally aligned with our beloved true parents. And especially why we are totally understanding why our true mother is going around the world and again telling us this. And let us respond to that positively. And I hope you take it. Okay? Thank you so much. God bless you.